In this video, let's talk a little bit about kind of an advanced topic, which is how we can embed a video from the new stream on SharePoint into another HTML location. So like say that you've got an intranet site that is not based in SharePoint, or you've got a learning portal or something like that that can take HTML iframe embed codes, and you can display video that way. It was something that we could do in the classic stream, but it's available in the new stream with a little bit of nuance to it. So I think it's a good thing to cover, even though it's a little bit of an advanced topic. So we're going to take one of the videos off of my SharePoint here, and we're going to generate an embed code for that video. So let's say that I've got this video up here at the top, my latest video. It's called New Stream Demo. I'm going to embed that into another web page, so I need to get an iframe code. So we're going to click on this, and we're going to open up the new video player. So this is the new stream on SharePoint video player experience. And the way that you easily share a video is just the red button up here at the top that says share. You can just click on that. You can click share or copy a link to it. You can copy a link at the current point in time if you want to. But at the bottom, there's the new HTML embed code. So if I want to generate the code, I can copy that, go paste it in my other platform. So we're going to click on that. We're going to click embed. And then I've got some options that are very similar to what I had in Stream Classic, right? I can start at a specific point in time. So if I want to turn that on, I can start 10 seconds into the video. I can change the size. So this is 360p. I can make it 720, 480p, 360, you know. I can auto play the video so that when the page loads, it just starts playing the video. I can make it responsive, or I can show and hide the title. And then down at the bottom, I've got, here's the text that I would click the copy button down here. And then I would go into my other platform and I would paste it in. Now, one thing that a lot of people haven't found yet that I just realized, somebody came to me recently saying, hey, I embedded an HTML page, right? I generated the code, I put it in our intranet, and then nobody could get to the video, right? Like I got a whole bunch of problems, you know, with people not being able to get to the video. It's important to note that this embed screen, this is just for generating the ability to display where the video is, right? It does not give permissions to the video. That is done in another place, right? These iframes, these HTML embeds, they only use existing permissions for whether or not that person can access that type of video. So what we need to do is we need to give people access to this particular video. Now, this is explained up here at the top. It's just something that people, you know, they generally don't read text. So up at the top, it says only viewers with access will be able to see this video. So we've got to go fix that first. So I'm going to close this embed out, and there's a few ways that we can give access to this particular video. I'm going to get a visual aid up here and talk about the structure, like my recommended structure for how I think you should organize your videos on SharePoint is that you've got a SharePoint site, you create folders on that SharePoint site, and then you put your videos in those folders. That's about the closest construct to having a stream channel that we used to have in Classic. So I can share videos, I can give access to videos in one of three levels. I can give access to an individual video, I can give access to the folder where my videos reside, or I can give access to the entire site at the top level. So I'm going to show you the three ways that you can give access to those videos. Now, one other little way, thing to explain is there's two types of URLs whenever we go to share video in SharePoint and OneDrive for sharing files in general. There's the sharing links that we're all familiar with. If I go and I click share and I open up this sharing thing and I copy that link, right? If I look at this link, it's a bunch of gibberish, right? It doesn't really match the link up at the top right here. the link at the top in your browser, that is the path to get to that particular file. When you generate a sharing link, Microsoft abstracts that a little bit. And there's two reasons why they abstract and they rewrite that URL. One, that gives you the ability to have multiple sharing links, right? If we go back into here and we edit the permissions on this sharing link, we can choose everybody in the company. We can give it to specific people. So we can have different links with different types of settings, right? One of them you can edit the file, one of them you can only view the file. By abstracting that link out, you have the ability to have unique links for different types of permissions. The other reason why Microsoft abstracts this URL when you go get a sharing link is it allows you to move files around really easily and not break the links that you created. All these generated links right here, I can move this file to another SharePoint site. I can check a box that keeps all of the existing sharing intact. And then what will happen is Microsoft will redirect all of those existing links to the new location where the video is. So there's two reasons why they make that kind of a, you know, messy URL that's abstracted. The second type of URL is the actual URL up here at the top of my site, right? So I've got the path to this video. It's my SharePoint site called Office 365 Adoption. And then it's got a bunch of folders, right? Documents, shared documents, my channel, and then the video itself. This is the raw path to the video inside of SharePoint. Now, the embed code that you make, the HTML code, that is going to this raw path. So we've got to give people access at that file level rather than just creating a vanity link to get to the video. I hope that kind of makes sense. It's a little bit kind of roundabout explanation, but suffice it to say, we need to give people access to the video itself. And we can do that at the file level, the folder level, or the site level. So I'm going to start with giving access at the file level. Say that this is just a single video. I need to share it with everybody in the company. And it's not my job necessarily, right? I'm just a one-off video sharing it with everybody with a HTML embed code. So to do that is really easy. It's actually on the same page as the player. So when we went down to embed code, just go down one more option, go to manage access. This is how we control access at the file level. So we're going to click on that. And you can see it's already got some pre-made groups, but I just want everybody in the company to get to this file without problems. So I'm going to click the plus button right here to grant access. And then I'm going to use a built-in group that's built in natively to Microsoft 365. And that is everyone except external users. That's going to come up. That is a built-in group that's just everybody in the company. So I'm going to select that. And then I don't want them to edit this video, right? So I'm going to click the pencil. I'm going to click that they can view the file only, but they can't make changes. And then I don't think Microsoft is going to email everybody in the company, but just to be safe, I'm going to uncheck notify people. I don't want to notify these people. I just want them to be able to get to the file. I hit grant access. Now, if I go into share the video and hit embed, I can be sure that everybody in my company will be able to watch that video on that other external, non-365 HTML site. So that's the file level. Now, what about the folder level? This would be the use case of, say I'm in a communications team, and let's go back to the graphic. Say that I have my communications site, brand marketing, internal marketing, and I've got different folders. Let's say that one of my folders, maybe I want to create a really easy workflow for me as a video creator. I'll create a folder called published videos. And my workflow is going to be that while I'm working on videos in draft format, they'll be in some other folder. But when I'm ready to publish and I want everybody to see every video that's in this folder, I'm just going to pick up the video. I'm going to drop it into the published videos folder. And because I've set the permissions at the folder level, I know that everybody in my company can access that video. So let's do that. Let's go back over here and we're going to go to the folder level. I've got this folder called Teams Tip Tuesday right here. We're going to go into that folder and I want everybody to access every video that I put into this folder. I don't care, you know, to do it at an individual video level. So to give access to this whole folder, I'm going to go up one level. You see Teams Tip Tuesday right here? That's inside of the document library, the main document structure. I'm going to click on that. And then for Teams Tip Tuesday, I'm going to click this dot, dot, dots, or the more actions right here. We're going to click on that. And then we're going to click Manage Access at the folder level. We click Manage Access. And then again, just like before, you click the plus sign. And then you want to put everyone except external. There's that built-in group. We're going to click that. We're going to give them read-only access. So change the pencil to the slashed out pencil. We're not going to notify people. And then we're going to grant access. So now I don't have to go do that for every single video. All I've got to do is I've got to drop a video into this folder. And then on the video, I can just simply go in here to stream. I can click the embed code and I can copy that. I can do all my settings. I don't have to worry about whether or not people can get to it because it's in the right place, right? So that is at the folder level. The last way to do this is at the site level. So again, we've done individual video. We've done folder. Now, what about sharing the entire site? Every file on the site is going to be available. I can do that as well. What I do is I just go up another level, right? So I've got the folder and I'm on this site called Office 365 Adoption. So I want to share like the whole site with everybody. I can make this public if I want to. It's already a public group, or I can get into the actual like site permissions and do that everyone except external. I'm going to click the gear icon right here. Then I'm going to go to site permissions. And then I can go here to advanced permissions. I can click on that. And then I can grant permissions in the upper corner right here. It's kind of old school SharePoint. We click on that. We do everyone except external users. It comes up with that, you know, built-in group. I'm going to show options. I am not going to give an email invitation, right? And then I don't want them to be members. I just want them to be able to read the site. I just want them to be able to like look at stuff, but not edit anything. So I'm going to read, hit share, and then now I've done it at the site level. So you can, you know, do it however broadly you need to. Then whenever you embed, you build embed codes. You don't have to worry about whether or not somebody can get to it. So hopefully that helps explain the situation about like, I created this embed code. People said they couldn't watch it. It's because you didn't give them access to the video. This explains how you give that access. So if you have any questions, leave a comment down below. I'm happy to answer. And thanks again for watching.